come a long way, my friend. Across oceans, deserts.
Season of the Witch, where Nicolas Cage and Ron Perlman play crusaders fighting in the name of God to bring glory to God, and they discover that it turns out they're killing women and children, and then the plague comes and they get a mandate from the king to end the plague, and it turns out that involves dealing with witches and sorcerers and maybe the devil, and they have to go on an adventure and slay the dragon. Not quite, but they go on an adventure with a rich, colorful band of characters to perhaps meet their due.
That the witch.
That is not what I say. I will take the girl, but if she is not what you say, she will not be yours to burn.
You're not like the others. Do you believe I'm a witch, Bayman?
Don't be deceived. She sees the weakness that lies in our hearts. And what she sees there, she will use against us.
You're not afraid of me. Are you?
These men are prepared for battle.
They have to get in line behind me.
She'll turn one man against another.
They must be punished.
Let's finish this.
We're gonna need more holy water.
So there's a little glimpse of Season of the Witch. You get a sense of what goes on. They go into the petrified forest and they have got to get to the castle to uncover the secret. How many movies does Nicolas Cage have to come up with some sort of tablet? Some sort of book of secrets which he uncovers and then the all is revealed and that's what saves people. I mean, it's got to be six.
I wish this were as fun, though, as some of the bad Nicolas Cage movies of yore. This isn't even, like, bad in a fun way. And the fact that his hair is all, like, messy and it's a little bit puffy kind of gave me some hope that this might be, like, weirdo Nicolas Cage, and it's not.
You know, there's they talk about tone, as we did in Country Strong. There's a tonal problem in the beginning of this movie where the Matt's like, what are you talking tonal? You shouldn't even be talking about tonal problem.
Where was there a tonal problem? Right.
But I mean, you got the king, leading the Crusades or the
cardinal,
I'm
gonna go with cardinal
for the
Christopher Lee.
No, that's different.
That's who sends him up on their.
I'm talking about the guy.
You're talking about the guy who keeps quoting scripture and kill the infidels.
Ride ye in the glory of God, all that nonsense of, ride
that
ye.
Could be a king.
Pretty sure he doesn't say ride ye. and so he's talking in that, in that 14th century way, and then Nicolas Cage is like, who's buying drinks later?
Right.
And that it's a little like.
And Ron Perlman sounds like he's back in Brooklyn.
Totally, yeah.
You're going to be buying drinks, buddy.
Yeah, it looks like these drinks are on you. And then the king still and the other guys are talking about, the other guys sound like Mel Gibson. In Braveheart. And I thought maybe, like you say, I thought maybe that might lead to fun, that there might be a degree of that would be offset throughout the movie and that would be the sort of source of humor, that there would be this 21st century language offset with the 14th century movie, the movie version of 14th century language. But that wasn't the case. It seemed to be just sloppiness.
I think they were trying to establish that kind of an anachronistic fun gimmick, but the writing isn't like smart or clever or snappy or fun enough to make that work at all, so it's sort of a waste.
I wanted this movie to be at least fun. I like Nicolas Cage, I like Ron Perlman, and I actually thought they, in spite of all the other problems in this movie, they did have kind of a bit of chemistry that I would have liked to have seen. I'd like to see them cast together in something else. I think that they would work really well together.
I thought they did have chemistry. I did. Really? I thought there were a couple of nice moments with them. I didn't think it was as unfun as you guys did. I mean, don't get me wrong. I did not have fun.
But Nick Cage is a total drag in this. I mean, you want crazy Nick Cage in this sort of setting.
No, I thought he was kind of the weary crusader. I thought he was okay.
Droning the whole time?
He was fine. I thought he was fine. I thought Ron Perlman gave it his all like he always does.
Ron Perlman gave some life to it, and I did think their interplay was pretty good. I thought when we got to the end with the demon, I honestly don't even quite know what that was.
He was Satan, right?
That's what I think, but it was pretty weak. And that looked fake.
Totally fake CGI
Satan. It was a bad Satan. And I didn't think that anything prior to that.
There's a good Satan?
Yeah.
Not, Elizabeth Hurley?
But I didn't think that it was, I didn't have any problem with how things looked before then. I mean, I wouldn't be bragging about how things looked, but that seemed really lazy.
I don't know. Some, you know, the crusade scenes look kind of cheap. We've seen other movies.
I thought Satan looked particularly cheap.
Well, right. But I mean, the early scenes in the Crusades when they're supposed to be in the Middle East, it's like, oh, they got a cast of dozens for this one.
It's like the same fight scene recycled with like different lighting or whatever. Right. Like it's like over, all interchangeable. I thought the Satan looked cheesy, but so did the zombie ninja monks. Because there's like monks and they're dead, but they become undead.
That was all in the last scene.
Zombie ninja monks should be awesome.
They should be
awesome. That should be awesome.
That's a great idea.
I liked that a lot of people had the plague. That was kind of cool.
Christopher Lee is like ravaged by the plague.
Why even bother cast Christopher Lee?
In one scene.
Why even bother? That's my
waste.
Question.
Like,
there was. It turns out all that happens with the plague is you get horrible goiters.
It's not pleasant.
No. I'm sorry. I thought it was pleasant. I didn't mean to make fun of any of our bubonic viewers. I totally apologize. So I guess I thought it was a little more fun than you guys did. And I just want to mention, because he wasn't in it enough, but Stephen Graham, who's a really wonderful actor, he plays their guide. And I did think he brought a bunch of levity to it. It was
killing. I kept thinking was Donnie Wahlberg.
He was Wahlberg-esque.
Because he kept speaking like he was from the East Coast.
He did Brooklyn-y accent.
He's
English.
I never thought that was Donnie Wahlberg.
No, but he sounded Brooklynish.
But you didn't watch Band of Brothers.
Yeah, I did.
You did?
Yeah.
You watched Band of Brothers. You don't mistake anybody.
15 years ago?
I saw it again. I've seen it twice. Good. No, I loved it. That's why. I got the Blu-ray.
Does Patrick Wilson know you have a thing for Donnie Wahlberg?
I'm not telling.
It's not that kind of a thing for Donnie Wahlberg. And Patrick's fine with it. We have an open relationship. But he was in, it was killing me what he was in that I recalled him from most recently, and plays a young Al Capone in Boardwalk Empire. But he's great, and he should have been in it longer. That's all.
Okay.
So, Matt?
The chemistry between Perlman and Nicolas Cage went a long way with me. I thought that it's nice to see Perlman have that much of a movie without makeup, and so I gave it a 4.5.
All right.
Wow. Crystal? 1.5? There may be a couple of funny lines here and there.
1.5. So I gave it. I just thought it was an average movie. I didn't hate it. I gave it a 5.
Wow. But
I mean, I wouldn't recommend it. I mean, that's great.
Well, and nobody's recommending it. I should point out that the tomato meter for this movie is a whopping 2%.
Really, 2. Yeah. What I like is that I hated Country Strong slightly more than Christy hated Season of the Witch.
It's all relative.
But it's competitive.
It's January.
Yeah,
is right. What it is.
It's a lovely
it's time
January.
Of year.
So go see as it's opening wider this week. Go see I Love You, Philip Morris. If you're looking for a new movie.